Okay, brothers, sisters, I know that it's quite a risk to talk about the relationship between men and women, because for obvious reasons it's a dicey affair, but I'm quite sure if you're married or not, and if you just know men, you know women, you know it's a complicated little affair, eh? It's not for nothing that they call it the battle of the sexes, eh? Because often it ends up in a bit of a battle, eh? Okay, so what I've once heard on a in a movie was struck me, and it was a woman saying the following words: "I am a woman. We never ask for what we want, but we reserve for ourselves the right to be angry if we don't get what we want." Has that been true? I think so. Maybe got some heads shaking there. Okay. So the thing is, in relationships, it's usually a problem to ask, eh? Asking is complicated. Because if you ask somebody something, you actually need something from them, eh? So we're not big on the asking thing. We usually do some other stuff to try and bring our message across. Like the poor girl there trying to ask, when, Darby, what are you doing on Monday in the puppet show? And then Darby said, no problems. But actually, she meant, what are you doing on Monday? Because I want to do something with you, eh? I kind of like it, eh? Now she's running away in tears, but he hasn't got a clue what's going on. What is happening? He just said what he's doing on Monday. Okay, so we've got this thing between men and women. And now what happens is that we often end up in a bit of a war, eh? Because I want this, and you want that. Never the twain shall meet, eh? That is one song, maybe you know the song, it goes like this. Every day is like survival. You're my lover, not my rival. Hey, that's how the song goes. We're supposed to see, love each other, but oh my goodness, it's more of a war than anything else, huh? So that often happens. So, the problem is complicated when we now try to ask something from each other, eh? So now we have a bit of a war, but it's more complicated than that. Because actually the mind of a woman and the mind of a man does not function in the same way. And I'm not thinking this out. I'm actually have got some evidence about this. And this is evidenced in this short clip we're going to watch about a marriage counselor trying to explain the difference between the brain of a woman and the brain of a man. So he actually on stage, he's got a brain of a man and a brain of a woman, and I was trying to explain what is the difference. And he's saying, how do you, in this particular clip, he's trying to explain, how do you ask a man to do something for you? Eh? We don't like to ask, and we often ask too much. But now he sort of explains the whole concept in the short movie clip. Okay, well, so there you can see, he's trying to explain that men's brains, women's brains, it does not work in the same way. One of the first things my wife told me when we met, she said that exactly this, she said, women can do many things at the same time. You can multitask, you're brilliant. But you men, you can only do one thing at a time. I mean, you're not very bright. We can do one thing. The thing is, we can do one thing very good, because we can focus on one thing. That's the thing that we're doing, whether it is watching TV or like working on a car or something. But that thing we can do very good, eh? We're brilliant at that one thing. But don't confuse us by telling us five different things. Now, what I find very strange concerning my wife is that this is the first thing she told me, and since then she's been very angry at me every time I could not do five things at the same time. That I do not understand. Okay, so you have to take that into consideration. Okay, so what he's saying is this: we are not that bright. I mean, we can do the one thing, we can do many things at the same time. But now what happens is that you ask us one thing, and as you said, in the ear, in one ear and the other ear, and we didn't like register this, eh? Because we're busy with something else at that moment. Eh? So what happens now is that the woman becomes very irritated with the man. I mean, she's now asking something, and he's not doing it, and it's not happening. And as you heard, she's now waiting for 6 months, and he's still not doing it. But he has long forgotten all about that question. Eh? But now she's still angry, and that complicates the whole process. Then he becomes in a war, and he's not really sure what's going on in this war. What did he do wrong? He couldn't remember anything. Okay, so that is what happens. And another thing is, as he said, explained, actually women want men to sort of feel cosmically, somebody was whispering in their ear, you must now do something that you wanted to do, eh? Now, I'm sorry to say this, but no, that's not very realistic. I mean, that's very romantic. The romantic idea is that we will sort of know what you want and then do it, eh? But I'm sorry to say that's not going to happen. We are basically clueless, eh? We do not know what you want. If you don't tell us what you want, you're not going to get it. That's basically the way it works, I'm sorry to say. Another thing is now that, sometimes women like to test a man. Now he tells another story about this woman coming to him and crying with him and telling him, she's so sad because her husband washes the dishes. And he's like, asking, why are you sad? That's awesome. And that's the all the men can just wash the dishes, that's brilliant. Now she's saying, no. And then I asked him, why does he wash the dishes? And his answer was, because I don't like dirty dishes standing around. And now she's in a state, because she wanted him to say, I wash the dishes because I love you. You see, that is just not realistic. Now what's happening? She and I had a little test, the test of love. The test is, what is he going to say he loves me? And then he failed the test, terrible. And the worst of it all is, he hasn't got a clue what he's done wrong. I just washed the dishes because the dishes are there. That's basically it. It's not complicated, it's obvious. But now she expected, with a little test, she expected the love thing. It's nothing to do with the love, he just washes the dishes. Men's brains and women's brains, we don't work in the same way, and we hate each other because we're expecting him to do something, but he doesn't have a clue you want him to do it. Okay. The important thing is we have to take each other into consideration. That is very important. Okay, so now I must, in a sense, ask you ladies, when did you ask a man or a boyfriend or something to do something, and you only asked him once, and you kind of, you're still kind of angry at him because he didn't do it that way. Are you sure he knows why you're angry at him? I wager to say he doesn't have a clue. You are very angry. He does not know what's going on. He's going through his small little brain and thinking, what did I do last? What did I ask? I can't remember. And it's not. So please give him a break. Huh? That's what this guy is saying. We have to give each other a break. So, and then there's another thing that women do that is, because we don't like to ask him, because there's a sort of a power relation in asking. That means you need something, eh? And we don't like to, that's why we don't like to ask, eh? So what we do is the next thing, we sort of give a hint, we sort of insinuate something, eh? And to be honest with you, ladies, we have got to do it. Okay? So if you sit there and you're cold, but you actually want a hug, and you say, oh, it's very cold, and he's going to bring you a jersey. He's not going to happen. That's what's going to happen. I'm telling you, he does not have a clue about this little insinuation that you actually want this, and you're going to be very disappointed. And I'm telling you this, you're going to be disappointed for more than once. Often. Because we're basically clueless. Please just listen to me. Okay, so what I'm saying is this, we have to take each other into account. First thing, obviously, the man can not only just stay clueless, he has to learn. We have to learn how to work with each other. So ladies, please, just give him a break, and maybe just ask him, just make sure he knows why he's in trouble now, eh? By asking him again, that would be nice. Maybe three times would probably be better, so that he's probably been busy doing something else. And guys, this is very important. You need to wake up. Huh? You need to open those ears and listen to what she's actually asking. But don't make it too difficult for you because it's not very bad. Just make it sort of acceptably easy. Eh? If you can understand it, that doesn't mean you can. Eh? So just give each other a break. So now we have got this passage that we've read that there's a sort of a relation between men and women, and there's a sort of a power relation saying you must submit yourself, be subject to the husband, eh? So all the men like that verse, they quote it from the Bible, and then they can do anything, eh? That's absolutely nonsense. The first verse says, subject yourselves to one another, eh? We must subject ourselves to one another. And then it says the man is the head of the household, that's fine. But it says, the man is the head of the household, like Jesus is the head of the church. And for this church, he laid down his life, he died for this church. Yeah? So for a man to try and use this little verse to subjugate women, to say they are less, that's absolutely nonsense. That's not what the Bible says. That's what we talked about. Yeah? That's not true. It means serving one another, being subject to one another. In that sense, being subject to God himself. That is why it's a very important thing to church. In church, we come and we bow our heads before God. And in a sense then, we bow to each other and say, we subject ourselves to one another in love. And that is what love is. Now it's interesting, in this passage, actually, God knows when he reigns. It's interesting in this passage, it is said four, no less than four times. It says, husbands, you must love your wives. Four times, the first time it didn't hear. And he says it again, you must love your wives like your bodies. And then he says again, you must love your wives like yourselves. Then God repeats it. So, for us to live in sort of semi-peace in this war of the sexes, I think it would be very wise. For maybe women just try to like repeat that question, that he just is on the same page with you, eh? If that's possible. But very important, you men must wake up. You must do stuff. Think up stuff to make her feel special. Eh? This is your work. You must do this before she asks, before she gets angry about all other stuff. Just think up something to make her feel special. That is what love is. Eh? It's small stuff. Let me repeat that. You men, you must love your wives. And you must make them feel special by thinking up stuff to give to them. Small little thing, a little flower always is great. When she does not expect it, when you did not do something wrong just before the time, when there's no reason why, just for love's sake, eh? Just make her feel special. Can I repeat that? You men, you must show your love to the women, to the girls, by doing something that she did not expect, that she did not ask. Not after you did something wrong, even for no reason at all. That's very important. And remember, God says you are the head of the house, but you must remember this head must bow before God himself. And that is what we read in another passage in scriptures. We read of Jesus Christ in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 25. The same word for the subjection is used here. And when all things have been subjected unto him, that is Jesus, then shall the Son also himself be subjected to him that did subject all things unto him, that God may be all in all. And that, brothers and sisters, is what love is. Subjecting ourselves to God and to each other.